I used to think that you got born and then you turned into a girl or a boy. But now I know that if you're a boy, you were born a girl. And if you're a girl, you were born a boy. You're just the way you're supposed to be. Baby girls grow up to be big girls and then men. Baby boys grow up to be big boys and then women. You're just the way you're supposed to be. You're just the way you're supposed to be. You're just the way you're supposed to be. You're just the way you're supposed to be.
I am your hostess for the evening, Chicka Chicka Nay Nay. And I would like to welcome you to the second annual Zombie Pinup Girl Pageant. Tonight, we have done something very, very special for all of you. Tonight, we have brought to you from the swamps of New Orleans, dancing with the witches of Brazil, smoking wampum with the headhunters of Africa, we have found the most exotic and beautiful creature known to man. These zombies are not your average grotesque zombies. All of these zombies died beautiful and young when they were pinup girls. And now, darlings, before we begin the show, there are three simple rules that you all must agree to abide by. This is not a safe pageant, oh no. These beautiful boozy bitches from hell, they feed on the brains of the living. And that is why there are three rules you must comply to. Number one, let's see. Oh yes, number one. Don't taunt the zombies. Number one, don't taunt the zombies. Number two, if you do taunt the zombies, there's only one way to stop them, and that's by blowing off their heads. So please feel free. And number three, the most important rule of all, please stand next to somebody smarter than you. For these zombies like big, juicy brains. So what that means is all of you faggots out there, stand next to a lesbian, will you? And without any further ado, Sissyboy would like to present our second annual Zombie Pinup Girl
Good number.
Before we get any further, let's meet our celebrity panel of judges, shall we? Over here, I have the infamous, the dead, Andy Warhol!
Wow, thank you. The funny thing is I never really died. I was always dead.
Your art was, darling. Alright, and next we have the evil, the spiteful, that's right. Everybody, give a round of applause for Hitler!
Zuccaro. For the record, I just want to say, I was not that terrible of a person. I just happened to have a lot of powerful men on top of me!
I know that story, Hitler. And last, we have Miss Jackie Onassis.
I first got my taste for brains when I ate my husband's in the back of a limousine.
You have a dirty side to you, don't you, Miss Nasty? All right. So, are you all ready to see more hot zombie action? All right then. We're gonna start with our evening wear. And first up is Miss Dead Marilyn Heroine Monroe. Now, Miss Marilyn Monroe, perhaps most famous for the most famous pinup girl of all, lived and died as a starlet. Born Miss Norma Jean, Marilyn climbed her way to the top on the backs of men, pills, and attitude. Let's just say her candle burned out long before her cocaine ever did. Miss Marilyn Monroe! It's all right, Jackie. You'll have your revenge. Next, we have Miss Zombie Cass. Miss Zombie Cass was born September 19, 1941, and died on July 29, 1974. Some say she choked on a ham sandwich, but she really died of a coronary explosion of the right artery due to her weight. Her love of food and liquor still lingers on in the afterlife. Thank you, Miss Zombie Cass. And our next contestant is Miss Zombulemia Ramsey. Miss Zombulemia Ramsey was born March 3rd, 1993, in an eating disorder clinic to a former Miss East LA. Zombulemia wanted to be pretty, just like her mama, and by the age of 6, she was already crowned Little Miss Eating Disorder, Little Miss Halloween, and Little Miss Chola. Unfortunately, Zombulemia's jealous mommy, hooked on crystal meth, dragged her to Springfield, Oregon, where her new stepdaddy lived. One year for Halloween, Zombulemia was naughty and got locked in her stepdaddy's meth lab. Well, actually, it was a year and a half. And now the bitch is dead. Sorry, Chola. Splendora the First, who is the great-great-great-grandmommy of Sissyboy's own Splendora. She was born 1810. And she tragically died in 1840 when she was traveling west of Texas with her husband Cornus. She was shot in the face by her own husband when he caught her in an orgy with an Apache chief and his drunk squaw Tammy, who used to do vaudeville with Splendora back in her hometown. It without any further ado, we're gonna move on to the sexy swimsuit part of our show, which also happens to be the Q&A. Are you ready to get to know some of our zombies? This pageant is not just about beauty and glamour and glitz and guts. It's about style, panache, and community service. So without further ado, I would like to bring up this beautiful swimsuit of Miss Mama Cass, Zombie Mama Cass. Zombie Cass. Now, before you leave the stage, Miss Zombie Cass, I must ask you a question. Now, as a suicidal fat girl, you spend a lot of time in purgatory. If there was one thing you could change about a waiting room, what would it be?
I need a buffet.
All waiting rooms should have a buffet, you're right. Thank you, Miss Sexy Fatso Fatso. Next, we have that terrible Texan, Miss Splendora. Splendora, if you could be alive for just, I don't have any brain stuff. If you could be alive for just one more day, what would you do? Tell us, how big was JFK after all?
Well, for the leader of the free world, he sure wasn't working worth nothing.
Jackie, relax. Back to your cage.
He was fun. He was real fun.
Afterlife. Alright, finally, last but definitely not least, we have Zombulemia Ramsey! Oh, she has her little kitty poo.
teach the world to sing, what song would you teach them?
Well, Zombulemia Ramsey was disqualified for points for throwing poo at the judges.
I thought you called yourself an artist. Hitler, are you having fun so far?
I say, Hindenburg called the missing the blimp.
Are you referring to Mama Cass? Darling, Jackie Onassis, I saw you actually get up on the stage and beat one of our contestants. What is that about?
If Marilyn Monroe had any brains, I would eat them.
That's just me. Alright. Where are we at? Next, I would like to bring up last year's pageant winner. This is the second annual Zombie Pinup Girl pageant, and as you all may recall, last year's winner was the lovely, the dead, Miss Polyanne Marie. Oh, thank you, Polyanne. You are looking as good as ever. All right. What I want to do now is tell you guys a little bit about what it means to be the winner of the Zombie Pinup Girl pageant. As I mentioned before, it is not just another pretty dead face. It is a commitment to our community. And that is why we are going to talk about what Bulimia did since the last pageant. First of all, as you can see above, Polyanne read to all the children of Portland in the library.
That's right. I believe that children are our most precious asset, and so I ate their brains.
Oh, Polyanne, we are all proud of you, aren't we, folks? Oh, darling, where am I? Now, okay, got it. Not only do we care about our community, but all Sissyboy pageant winners care about the environment. We have traveled the globe searching for the habitat of the endangered animals, such as the majestic condor.
The majestic, delicious condor. Country nutritious meals, and then I ate inner city children's nutritious brains.
But, darling, it wasn't all community service this last year. Must I remind you about the scandal? Miss Zombie Pinup Girl should be elegant, classy, and dead. But a scandal did erupt when Polyanne Marie posed nude for a gentleman's magazine. Shame on her!
But, if I could remind you, the judges and the committee ruled that the photos were not indecent as my sex organs dried up and fell out a half century ago.
Thank God for that one. Alright, now, Zombie Pinup Girls, I don't want you to think are just all beauty and community service. Believe it or not, because of all the brains they eat, they also have brains. Polyanne finished her master's in global economy and foreign language.
That's right, I was so proud, and it afforded me the opportunity to go to the Republican National Convention and serve as zombie to English translator for Arnold Schwarzenegger. Or, as we say in my native tongue. I really...
All right. I've been waiting for this all night.
Who's first?
And starting off is the beautiful Texan side swinger Splendora. She's coming with her husband Cornus, and I just need to tell you a little something about Splendora. She used to live in the Wild West in 1907, and she was known as a sharpshooter. She used to scalp Americans with the Indians, and she used to use her silver pistol to shoot the guns out of cowboys. And tonight, she is going to shoot an apple off the head of her husband, Cornelius.
Happy birthday to you. happy birthday to you.
Artistic stylings of Miss Zombulemia Ramsey.
Just
Karen Carpenter.
Is Andy, Hitler, Jackie, you have about 3 minutes. Well, these bitches change into their final outfits, and it can become Judgment Day.
I think they need more than 3 minutes.
Well, do you have anything to say, Andy?
Those are some undead bitches. They take their sweet time. How about you, Hitler?
Hitler, you're hot.
That's my Mr. President, Miss Monroe. That dick is on rental.
Alright, get over it, Jackie. She had his brother, too.
Alright, so let's bring up Miss Polyanne Marie also, because she has to take off her crown tonight. Come on up. How do you feel about losing your crown? What are you going to do now?
Well, I am going to miss all the politicians and the children.
And the brains.
And the brains.
Well, look at this healthy crowd tonight. Some of them look sort of smart.
No, I'm having to try my very Zombie Pinup Girl best not to eat anything
from y'all. That one over there looks delicious. Alright, let me see what's taking these bitches so long. Do you guys have any, like, zombie music or something? We need some time. Oh, darling, Hitler, what do you have to say?
We've come to our decision.
You ready?
We're ready.
Alright, without further ado, let's bring the contestants up one more time. We have Miss Marilyn Monroe, Heroine Monroe. We have the dead, the original, Miss Splendora. We have Miss Zombulemia Ramsey. Only one lady can carry the crown. Who is the second annual Zombie Pinup Girl?
Mama Cow.
Mama!
Sorry.